Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. If you rang in the new year and declared that this is my year, new year, new you, our next guest has all you have to do to set your intentions to make it so. Please welcome back to the show one of our favorite life coaches and author of the new book, Life Coaching for Successful Women, Valorie Burton.
Yes.
Green like money. We need it.
I know, that's right.
I love it.
You know, this week here at Sister Circle, we've been talking about 2020 transformations. And every year, it seems like everybody's like, okay, new year, new me. Yeah. Every year is the same confirmation, and we always let it fall by the wayside. So what are some practical steps to really make this year the best year yet?
You know, I think the most important thing is get clear about what you really, really want. Yeah. And don't, I mean, we all have a list. You might have 20, 30 things on your list, but what's most important? Because we get spread too thin, and we get spread too thin. It's really easy to just let everything fall by the wayside.
Yeah. So you talk about it's important being for women to get a life coach or to have a life coach. At what point do we make that first step?
Look, I've been coaching for almost 20 years. All my books have coaching tools in them. I think all of us can benefit from coaching. Coaching has gotten me through difficult family issues, through divorce, through finding my life love, having kids, all of those things. So it's really about stopping and being very intentional, about asking the kinds of questions that get you the answers you want. But most of us never stop and ask powerful questions.
Yeah, before we get to the question I'm supposed to ask you, I do have a problem with that. I don't have a mentor. People will look at, you know, they might look at your Instagram and think you have it all going on, but in that sense, I don't have a life coach, I don't have a mentor, anyone who's kind of guiding me through, because my career has been very non-traditional, and I don't know who I could look up to in that sense that can help me navigate my career. What do you say to people like me who seem to have it all but actually need guidance?
Well, I relate to exactly what you're saying when you're trying to carve out something that's not the norm.
Right.
And it really isn't about what you're carving out. It's what do you want? What are you fearing? What blocks do you need to move past? And one of my favorite questions is, how do you want to feel? Like you're going into a new year. Do you want to feel peace? Do you want to feel joy? Do you want to feel more confident? That will tell you what you need to be working on, what will give you that joy, what's going to give you that peace, what's going to give you that confidence.
Yeah, and there are three essential questions that you say all women should ask themselves. What are those questions?
Okay, so the first one is so simple, it's what do you want?
Yep,
now, there's
you
a couple,
said that.
Couple
yeah.
ways to look at that. What do you want is what is the goal that you're aiming for, but also we can get stuck in the rut of complaining, of being negative, of ruminating over what's going wrong. Stop yourself when you find yourself doing that and say, what do you want? Because we're so focused on what we don't want that we don't stop and say, well, what's the solution? How do I solve this problem?
Yeah.
So what do you want is a really important one. The second one I really love is, what will this goal give you that you don't have right now? Because you can just keep setting higher goals. I want to make more money. I want to get the promotion. I want to have more clients. I want the relationship. What's it going to give you that you don't have right now? There are always trade-offs. And sometimes we go after goals, and at the end of the day, we realize, I was better off where I was before. It wasn't worth all of that. So understand before you even move towards the goal what it's going to give you. I think that's really, really huge.
When we make our goals and we try to achieve success, and I don't want to quote you properly, you say what success looks like. It says it's measured by asking yourselves how others' lives are better because they crossed your path.
That's good.
So
like that.
Success is it outwardly focused, and is it about service?
Yeah, so when I talk about successful, success is a harmony of purpose, resilience, and joy. Are you doing what you are called to do using your gifts and experiences? Are you bouncing back over and over again? And is there joy? Because I don't think you're successful if there's no joy. So those two things are really important. And the purpose question is, how is someone's life better because they cross paths with you? You might be the entertainer, you might be the bridge builder, you might be the connector, but know what that purpose is.
Wow. Well, how can you be clear? Because
sometimes
I feel like God has given me so many different purposes, and some of them I'm able to see over the Christmas holiday by being able to see people I haven't seen.
Those are divine assignments within your purpose. My purpose is inspiring women to live more fulfilling lives. I do that through writing, through speaking. When my mother had a brain aneurysm, my purpose at that point was not being on the stage, not writing more books. It was inspiring one woman at that time.
Right,
so your purpose isn't just your career. It impacts your personal life, how you spend your money, why you take good care of yourself. So it's much bigger than just the individual goals.
Why you don't take care of yourself.
Valerie, what is one quality you think all successful women must possess?
I always say resilience.
That is so true.
You know this. All of you know this. All of you have a degree of success, and you know that there was failure along the way. Mm-hmm. There was discouragement. There was disappointment. And at mm-hmm. the end of the day, you have to say, all right, this is just a part of the journey. Mm-hmm. When am I getting up? Yeah. Allow yourself the space to mourn when you need to and to be mm-hmm. sad when you need to. But at some point, you got to get back up, look at your vision, and keep moving forward.
Yes. Yeah.
Speaking of serving, you are serving the people with a free online course.
Yes.
Tell us about that.
Yes, so we created a course to go with the book, and it's about how to self-coach, and it's free when you get the book.
Self-coach.
Yeah. Okay. Because a lot of times, even if you have a coach, your coach isn't with you all the time.
Right.
How do you stop
and
coach yourself to get the answers you need when you're dealing with challenges and dilemmas?
Wow, that is great. Well, she's given us a wealth of knowledge that we could go and we could go be our best selves.
Y'all
ready? Y'all ready? Well, 2020, we are ready. Be sure to pick up Valorie Burton's new book, Life Coaching for Successful Women, and check out her website, ValorieBurton.com. Let's give it up for the one and only
Thank
Valorie
you.
Burton.
Thank
we'll
you.
Be right back.
Yeah. So how do we do that when we're not taking care?